So we are starting with abdomen. And firstly, let's talk about the introduction. So although the abdominal wall, although we may feel abdomen is from here to here, but then what happens is the thoracic wall itself, you can just see, feel the thoracic wall and the rib cage, almost it is going till here, and here is the iliac crest. So on the sides, it is only this much. Anteriorly, it may appear that yes. So there are some characteristics of this anterior abdominal wall, and the most important characteristic is no deep fascia. No deep fascia. Why no deep fascia? Because we want to keep no deep fascia at two places. One, anterior abdominal wall, two, face, so that we can smile. We can keep and smile, keep and smile. Okay? So if we had a deep fascia here, then just after eating two chapatis, we would have felt full, or one chapati. Of course, all of us would be having a flat abdomen, like So all those people who are practicing yoga, you also would be having a flat. So now why we don't have a flat tummy? Because we don't exercise on this muscles. Therefore they lose the tone. Because they lose the tone, so we have to tone these muscles up. See, upper limb muscles, lower limb muscles normally don't require exercise because we are constantly using them. So we never develop weakness of upper limb, lower limb muscles. We develop weakness of neck muscles, so then after some years we start doing all these things, neck pain. We never exercise back muscles. How many of you do exercise of the back muscles? All this in our school may have for PT, physical education, or teacher then so then after few years we develop back. Same is with abdominal muscles. We never practice or we never exercise them, so they become lax. So then it starts bulging, of course. Another reason for bulging is that suppose this is the skin, and then layer 1 is skin, and then there is superficial fascia. This superficial fascia has two layers, fatty layer of camphor and membranous layer of scarpha. Layer of camphor and layer of scarpha. Okay? Superficial fascia is divided into two layers, camphor and scarpha. Fatty camphor and membranous scarpha. Now, then there is no deep fascia. This superficial fascia, even the membranous layer, it goes and gets attached on a line over here, which while studying lower limb, you may have heard the name Holden's line. Some of you may have heard the name Holden's line. So, if the way it gets attached is, it gets attached here like this and then goes around, goes below and gets attached to the perineal posterior border of the perineal membrane. So, something like this and lower down. In such a way that in case the urethra gets ruptured, the urine will never extravasate. I'll draw it and show it to you. Suppose this is the abdomen, this is the lower limb. So what happens is the superficial fascia goes and gets attached like this, the membranous layer and the fatty layers. And the genitals are here, suppose. And the urethra is here, the urethra gets ruptured. So because it gets attached like this on the deep fascia of the lower limb, the urine after urethra ruptures, if there is an injury on the perineum. Injury on perineum kabhi hota hai, if a lid of a mango is open or semi open and somebody steps into it. Jab aisa mango hai, ye uska lid hai aur kisne idhar step kiya and then it becomes like this and it hits exactly in the perineal region. So that time the urethra may rupture. So any injury in the perineal region, okay, that does not, वो फिल्म में वगैरह कभी कभी दिखाते हैं कि लेडीज ऐसे जेंट्स को ऐसे इधर मारते हैं, दैट इज दैट मे नॉट कॉज अ यूरेथ्रल रप्चर. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट अ मेटल ऑब्जेक्ट हिटिंग. सो देन दैट यूरेथ्रल रप्चर्स द यूरिन बिकॉज दिस सुपरफिशियल फेशिया इज सो फॉर्मली अटैच्ड हियर लाइक दिस. सो आफ्टर द यूरेथ्रल रप्चर द यूरिन एक्सट्रावाजेस इन द एंटीरियर आफ्टर द नोन and goes right up to the neck. So, what does it smell like? What does it smell like? What does it smell like? So, you have to remember why the urine extravasates in case of urethral ruptures upwards up to the neck and not to the lower limb, because the superficial fascia, the two layers of scarf on camera, they are attached to the Bolden's line and the perineal membrane in such a way that it cuts off the urethral area from the lower limb. So, ये lower limb का area है, उसका deep fascia है, so it is attached like this. So, therefore, in case of urethral rupture, there will be an extravasated happens. Now, skin, superficial fascia. No deep fascia and we directly reach the muscle. Now, right now I am drawing the area. I am drawing the sagittal section. This is the sagittal section. Skin, superficial fascia. I am drawing the sagittal section in anterolateral area, not the anterior most. Because here, anterior most in the center is a muscle called as rectus abdominis. Rectus means straight. This rectus abdominis muscle exactly is in the center like this. It has tendinous intersections. It differs in person to person. Some people may have two tendinous intersections. So if they exercise this muscle, they get six packs. Some have three. So the muscle is divided into four parts. So they get 8 packs. Okay, so that does not depend on your exercise. It depends upon how many tendinous intersections you have in the rectus abdominis muscle. Now we are not talking about the central portion where there will only be one muscle. Now I am talking about the anterolateral portion where there are three muscles. Like we had three muscles here in the thoracic wall. So this first muscle which we come across is external oblique muscle. External oblique muscle. Now external oblique muscle and then inside the external oblique muscle is internal oblique muscle and then is transversus abdominis. So skin, superficial fascia, external oblique, internal oblique and transversus abdominis. Now what is the difference between these three muscles? External oblique, the fibers will be directed downwards, forwards, medially, the way we put our hands. So the fibers are external oblique. Look here, external oblique origin is on the lower ribs. Origin is from the lower ribs and it goes down. You all have studied the iliac crest. On the iliac crest, outer lip, anterior part, and outer lip is external only. Inner lip is transverse subterminus and intermediate part is internal only. So on this, you have to remember there is a difference. When we talk about external oblique, on the outer lip of the iliacus, it is insertion. While internal oblique and transverse subterminus is the origin. Even if you see the diagram in your book, the colors are different. Right? There is a different color for origin, different color for insertion. So external oblique takes origin from the lower ribs and goes downwards, forwards medially and gets inserted on the iliacus. Okay, so suppose these are the lower ribs, so it takes origin from here. Okay, and here is the iliacus, goes for insertion on the iliacus. Okay, in the center here is xiphoid process. Here is pubis and pubic tubercle. Pubic symphysis, pubic tubercle. Now what happens is this external oblique, you remember external intercostal? When it came anteriorly, it became a membrane. Here also, there is up, they become aponeurotic. So the muscle will take origin like this, okay? Go for insertion over here. And then when it comes in this area, so here is the muscle fibers, which go down and get inserted on the iliac crest. And when they come in this region, they become a aponeurosis. Yahan pe fibers hai pure. And this aponeurosis is attached to the linea alba down here. Now here is the lower border of external. This lower border of external oblique, this lower border of external oblique is nothing but inguinal ligament. So yahan pe uska, just look here, yahan pe uska insertion khatam ho gaya iliac crest outer lip, and from iliac crest outer lip, anterior most point is anterior superior iliac. From there to pubic tubercle, the lower border of external oblique is thickened to form inguinal ligament. Everybody understood what is inguinal ligament? Sir? Yes, sir. What is inguinal ligament? It is the lower thickened border of external oblique muscle. Yeah? External oblique. So now, अपना external oblique ये है ना, तो मैं उसको ऐसे lower down, what is this? You are looking from the side, inguinal ligament. There is internal oblique. Now internal oblique I show on this side. Internal oblique, and here is inguinal ligament. Internal oblique will take origin from the intermediate area of the iliac crest and go above for the insertion of the ribs. Okay. It also takes origin from the lateral 2/3 of the inguinal ligament. Lateral 2/3 of the inguinal ligament. And here is a fascia called as thoracolumbar fascia. I don't know whether you are hearing this word for the first time, thoracolumbar fascia. So it takes origin from thoracolumbar fascia also. So intermediate area of the iliac crest, anterior part, and lateral 2/3 of inguinal ligament and thoracolumbar fascia. Goes upwards to the insertion of the lower ribs. Okay. While transverses, again this also, this muscle also will form a aponeurosis. also give a aponeurosis as it comes on the medial part. Again, the aponeurosis gets attached from linear alba. On the linear alba. Linear alba, what is linear alba? Exactly in the center. Exactly in the center. From zygoid process to the pubic symphysis. Where the fibers of external oblique aponeurosis, internal oblique aponeurosis, transversus abdominis, all of them interlace with each other to form linea alba. Okay? It's a very easy area to operate in emergency. Center mein cut karo kuch bhi fibers, but then not advisable. Because that weakness will remain. Only in emergency we use this. Okay. Now coming to transversus abdominis. Transversus abdominis. Transverse. Now understand this. External oblique is on the ribs. External oblique is on the ribs. Internal oblique is at the level of the ribs. मतलब ये रिब केज ऐसा है तो एक्सटर्नल ऑब्लिक उसके ऊपर है इंटरनल ऑब्लिक उसके लेवल पे है पर ट्रांसवर्सस एब्डोमिनस ऑलमोस्ट उसके अंदर है ट्रांसवर्सस एब्डोमिनस इज ऑलमोस्ट बिहाइंड इंटरनल ऑब्लिक एट द लेवल एक्सटर्नल ऑब्लिक एंड द ट्रांसवर्सस एब्डोमिनस टेक्स ओरिजिन फ्रॉम द लोअर रिब्स टेक्स ओरिजिन फ्रॉम द थोराकोलंबर फेशिया takes origin from the iliac crest, takes origin from the lateral one third of the inguinal ligament and runs transversely. Okay, it runs transversely, again forms aponeurosis and linear. So its attachments are again like this on the sides, the muscle runs transversely. So everybody got this orientation? So one muscle going like this, one muscle going like this, one muscle going like this, to form a mesh, because यहाँ पे 1.5 किलो का लीवर है, आप 1 किलो 2 किलो खाते हो वो है, 2 लीटर पानी पीते हैं वो है, and then उसके बाद all intestine, everything is here. So there should not be, these organs need support. Especially in lower animals, हम लोग तो खड़े हैं, वो लोग तो ऐसे, lower animals. उनका तो सारा gravity भी वो organs को मदद करे, so therefore this mesh like arrangement, in all animals, this arrangement is there. So to provide support, especially this mesh like arrangement is helpful in lower animals. Okay. Now let us talk about the muscle which is in the center. The muscle which is in the center, this takes origin from the pubic symphysis and the pubic tubercle, or rather the pubic crest. Right? Yaad hai aapko hip bone? This is symphysis. So pubic crest ending in pubic. So it takes origin from the pubic crest, pubic tubercle. There are two muscles, eighty-third or eighty-third. And this also goes and gets inserted over the layer, lower three to four ribs. This muscle is rectus abdominis. The origin of rectus abdominis is pubic crest, pubic tubercle. And goes upwards and gets inserted on lower 3 to 4 ribs. Okay. Normally these muscles are attached to lower 3 to 4 ribs. Some muscles are attached to 5 ribs, 6 ribs. Okay. So this goes for insertion. And this muscle shows this tendinous intersections. Like this. So these are the tendinous intersections. So we now have 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6 ये हमारे अंदर भी है अगर हम एक्सरसाइज करेंगे ये एक्सरसाइज विल आल्सो डेवलप द सिक्स पैक सम पीपल मे हैव वन एक्स्ट्रा 8 पैक और अगर आपको एक पैंटी का दर्द होने का एक कंजेनाइटल है भाई, तो उसमें क्या दिक्कत? सो सम पीपल हैव दिस, ओके, बट ओके, अनलेस वी एक्सरसाइज, व्हेन वी एक्सरसाइज, व्हाट हैपेंस दिस मसल्स हाइपरट्रोफी, बट देयर इज नो हाइपरट्रोफी इन दिस एरिया, बिकॉज़ यहां पे मसल फाइबर ही नहीं, देयर इज टेंडिनस इंटरसेक्शन, तो वो एरिया में हाइपरट्रोफी नहीं होता है, इसके लिए देन इट लुक्स लाइक दिस. Therefore, the muscles are told. So then that 6 packs, 8 packs happens. All of us have only 1 pack, single. Don't, why also have 1 pack? Nerve supply is by lower nerves, some T7 to T12, some have T6 to T12. So the lower thoracic nerve supply these muscles. What is the action of these muscles, abdominal muscles? First action you have to buy, they support the abdominal viscera, okay. Then expulsive acts are two. One expulsive act is pushing the abdominal contents down, so that in defecation, parturation, childbirth, okay, defecation, sometimes even urination, but sometimes not. So this is pushing abdominal content out of the abdomen and pelvis. Third is forceful expiration. Coughing, sneezing. I don't know how many of you had some cough for a long time. Or uske baad some days na wo dukhne lagta hai abdomen. People are scared to cough because this abdominal muscles get fatty. Anybody had experienced this at any point? One. So three actions ho gaya. One, support. Two, expulsive action like defecation, and third, forceful expiration as in coughing, sneezing, and the thing which we are going to learn today, kapal bhati prana. फोर्थ एक्शन क्या हो सकता है? फोर्थ एक्शन, चलो दिमाग बत्ती चलाओ. फोर्थ एक्शन फ्लेक्शन ऑफ द स्पाइन, बिकॉज फ्लेक्शन ऑफ द स्पाइन. तो इसके लिए व्हेन वी हैव टू टोन दिस मसल्स, वी टेल समबडी स्टैंड ऑन माय लेग्स इन अ लाइन डाउन पोजिशन एंड वी डू व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एब्डोमिनल क्रंचेस, राइट. So what we are doing? Flexion of the spine. We are doing flexion of the spine. Lateral flexion of the spine also. Some people desire a shape like this. How do we reach the V? So therefore, if you go to the gym, you see people holding the weights in the hand and they do something like this. So lateral flexion of the spine is also action of the abdominal muscle. So when we do the lateral flexion, so flexion mein kuch nahi hota hai, when bringing it back, when bringing it back to the normal, my this side muscles keep contracting. So when I go down like this, bringing it back to the normal, my this side abdominal muscles keep contracting. So ये ऐसे एक साल करने के बाद वो भी आता है. आएगा ना, बिकॉज दीज मसल्स गेट टोन्ड अप. ओके, यहाँ पे मसल होता है, नॉट नेसेसरी टायर्स होता है. देयर इज मसल, नॉट ऑलवेज दैट देयर इज फैट ओवर हियर, मसल आल्सो. देयर इज अ स्कोप ऑफ गेटिंग इट टोन्ड अप. सो दीज आर द फोर एक्शंस ऑफ द अबडोमिनल. Let's go little behind. And see what is there. Beyond transverse abdominus is fascia transversalis. Fascia transversalis. Fascia transversalis. Extra peritoneal connective tissue, EPCL, किसी चैनल का नाम लगता है. Extra peritoneal connective tissue and then parietal peritoneum. Parietal peritoneum. Parietal peritoneum. So what are the layers of the anterior abdominal wall? All in the lateral part. Skin, superficial fascia, external of the, internal of the, transverse abdominus, fascia transversalis, extra peritoneal connective tissue and now we will talk about the central portion. Now we will talk about the central portion. Central portion, there is only rectus abdominis. Okay. Now this rectus abdominis, how many there are rectus abdomini? Right? We said that there is one rectus abdominis and there is another. So if we take cut sections, in the upper part, lower part and middle part. So in the cut section, this is one rectus abdominis. This is another rectus abdominis. Each mein kya hai? बीच में क्या है? लीनिया अल्बा. देयर इज लीनिया अल्बा.